गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू चैप्टर वन इंट्रोडक्शन टू ऑब्स कंसेप्ट एंड प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. सो फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड के व्हाट इज द लैंग्वेज. लैंग्वेज इज अ मोड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशंस. सो देयर इज द सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ नेचुरल लैंग्वेज दैट वी आर यूजिंग इन आवर रियल लाइफ सच एज हिंदी, इंग्लिश, तमिल, मलयालम एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. बट हेयर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. सो प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एनी प्रोग्रामिंग यूजिंग टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम. एंड अ पर्सन हु राइट द कोड इन अ प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज इज कॉल्ड प्रोग्रामर. नाउ हियर द वन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज अ कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेज. द कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेज इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू कैटेगरी. वन इज द हाई लेवल लैंग्वेज, सेकेंड वन इज लो लेवल लैंग्वेज. लो लेवल लैंग्वेज अगेन डिवाइडेड इंटू टू कैटेगरी, मशीन लैंग्वेज एंड असेंबली लैंग्वेज. मशीन लैंग्वेज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ जीरो एंड वन, दीज आर कॉल्ड द बाइनरी डिजिट्स. दिस इज डायरेक्टली अंडरस्टैंड वाई द कंप्यूटर एंड कंप्यूटर इज अंडरस्टैंड ओनली द मशीन लेवल लैंग्वेज. सो इफ वी आर राइटिंग एनी प्रोग्राम इन द मशीन लेवल लैंग्वेज, सो योर प्रोग्राम विल बी वेरी फास्ट बिकॉज वी नॉट रिक्वायर टू कन्वर्ट द वन लैंग्वेज इन टू अनदर लैंग्वेज बिकॉज मशीन लैंग्वेज इज डायरेक्टली अंडरस्टैंड why the computer. Second is assembly language. In assembly language some codes are used, that is called numeric codes and also called as symbolic names, but this is not understand by the computer. So we require the one translator, that is called the assembler, which is used to convert assembly level language program into machine level language. If we are writing a same program in high level language, so this is very easy to for the user or programmer because the form of high level language in simple English words, but the code will be little more as compared to assembly level language. So for convert the high level language into machine level language we require the translator. Now here is the some category of translator. There are three types of translator. One is interpreter, second is compiler. Both these are used for convert high level language into machine level language, but the main difference between an interpreter and compiler is interpreter is convert high level language program into machine level language program line by line, whereas the compiler is used for convert high level language program into machine level language program once at a time. So your program execution speed will be fast in which language, that is support compiler. And assembler is used to convert assembly level language program into machine level language program. Now here next topic is programming paradigms. Programming paradigms means approach or a principles of a program is known as programming paradigms. There are the three category of programming paradigms. Number one is procedure programming, second is modular programming, and third is OOPS programming. Older one, first is procedure programming. Here a large problem will be divided into small parts. These parts is known as procedures. So for solution of one problem, here we required multiple procedures for that solution. In modular programming, one module contains many procedures and these procedures are similar type. So one module contains a similar type of procedures. So your whole program will be divided only into three modules. Number one is input module that contains all the procedures that is used for input from the user in different types of input method. Second is processing module, which contains all the procedures which is used for perform the calculations. And third one is output module, which is contains all the procedures that we require to display a result in different formats. And the latest programming paradigm says OOPs. Now in the markets, all the languages support the concept of OOPs. So this is, as compared to procedure and modular programming, is very easy to understand, because here we can give some real life example. So this is easy to understand as compared to procedure programming and modular programming. Now your next topic is class and object. So here, for see the example, in this diagram, car is a class and Alto, Safari and Fortuner, these are the objects. So what is the definition of class and objects? A class contains a similar type of procedures, and object is an identifiable entity with some characteristics and behavior. How we can say a class is a collection of similar type procedures? Because if we are writing Alto or Safari or Fortuner, the name of the object of car, so Alto and Safari and Fortuner, all these are having the similar type of properties, such as four wheels, one steering, engine, etc., etc. Now these are the some OOPs concepts. So there are the four main OOPs concept is here. First one is data abstraction, second is encapsulation, third is polymorphism, and the last one is inheritance. Now what do you mean by the data abstractions? So data abstractions is required the essential features without including the background details. What are the meaning of without including the background details? Let's take an example is here. Suppose we want to, data abstractions means require the essential features without including the background details and explanation. Here we can take an example. Suppose we want to on a fan, so the essential features can be required to switch on the button of fan. So how the fan is moving, so we not required here the background details how the fan is moving, why, when we are switching the fan on. Third concept is polymorphism. Polymorphism means, poly means multi. So here we can represent a single thing in more than one form. And the last one is inheritance. It is used to inherit the properties of one class into another class. Now you can see the diagram here of inheritance. B class is inherited the data from A. So A is called a parent class or a super class or a base class. So a class which provide the data for drive class is called a parent class, and V here is called a child class because it is created with the help of A class. This is also called a subclass or drive class. Now here is some examples in which OOPs programming are used, such as object oriented database, parallel programming, networking, real-time systems, office automation, computer-aided designing, etc.